thing can do on this scale. So for that, I think we need to take it surfing. For your next qualifier, you'll need to prove you can take on the water flumes at high speed. Let's go. Hit it! Remember, surfing is all about balance. First flume coming right up. We'll take the speed boost to the top and skip the queue. Okay, next flume coming right up. Remember, you want to move with the water, not against it. Looks like you're going back to school at the academy. You're a pro rank now. Oh, and you can keep the Diora.
You made it through the qualifier. You are now officially an academy pro. I've added all the new events to your schedule. Something tells me you're gonna love these. How would you like to learn a bit more about Hot Wheels? Wanna learn about the famous orange track?
Absolutely! Be there soon!
It's time to learn about the greatest rivalry in Hot Wheels history. Meet me here. Snake or Mongoose? Come on down, I'll explain. Now that you're pro rank, we're ready to take the faster cars out of the garage. Don't get me wrong, we're gonna hit some eye-watering speeds up here, but we have to do this carefully. Each time you rank up at the academy, I'll let you drive faster and faster cars.
Turn left. right.
You're probably wondering what all this snake and mongoose talk is about, right? You take the yellow car, I'll take the blue. I'll explain along the way.
You've heard of Don Prudhomme and Tom McEwen, right? They were famous NHRA drag racers in the 70s, who had a friendly rivalry going on for years. Don was a four-time National Hot Rod Association champ and Motorsport Hall of Famer. He was nicknamed the Snake. Tom McEwen was another dragster who won the NHRA US Nationals. They called him the Mongoose. They were both well-established racers in their own right. As the two of them competed in the US Nationals over the years, they crossed paths numerous times, which sparked a friendly rivalry between them. Mattel proposed to make a series of toys based on the rivalry between the Snake and the Mongoose. The Hot Wheels sponsorship led to all kinds of drag-themed stuff. Lines back then. You had sets like the Rod Runner and the Big Belter, which launched cars with rubber bands. The Big Belter could even detect jump starts, which is pretty cool, right? These were a smash hit and propelled both Hot Wheels and drag racing to greater levels of fame. Heavyweights were designed to go faster on gravity drops, and Sizzlers had little battery-powered motors so you didn't need a launcher. And a new designer named Paul Tam started drawing six-wheel designs like Six Shooter and Open Fire. Stop there. There were loads of other innovations like tampo printed patterns on the cars, which no one else was doing. Then you had the Hot Wheels Collector's Club kit, where you could mail in to get either the Boss Puff, Heavy Chevy, or King Cuda, all with open hoods, big supercharger blowers, and silver paint jobs. Oh, so cool. Wish I'd been around back then. All this talk about drag racing has given me an idea.
The cars in the original Snake vs. Mongoose set were powered by rubber bands. These ones, well, aren't. How about you and I test them in a drag race?
Bring it on, Hayley. Let's go.
I can't believe that snake has a bite. Coming up on a loop. Keep your car in the middle. That concludes our lesson on centripetal force.
I obviously let you in, though. Who else am I going to give the keys to the Rip Rod?
There's something really special about taking a bunch of professional drivers, grouping them up into teams, and having them race. If you ever just want to race, Horizon Tour is your answer.
Thank you.